Welcome. We're continuing today in our daily devotions or daily devos with Ephesians chapter 2. The Word of God says, "And you were dead in your trespasses and sins, in which you formerly walked according to the age of this world, and according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit who now works in the sons of disobedience. Among them we all also once lived in the lusts of our flesh, doing the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature children of wrath, even as the rest." Amen. Well, we have, hopefully you had a chance to look at Ephesians chapter 1, which gives us a foundation naturally for Ephesians chapter 2, building on the first chapter, very, very powerful, very, very important revelatory passage and chapter, which gives us an understanding about the gospel of Christ, the revelation that Paul had, and our position in Christ, and what God has made available to us in Christ and through Christ. Now, in chapter 2, he begins by saying, "And you were dead in your trespasses and sins." You were dead in your trespasses and sins. So when the Bible talks about this, about us being dead, naturally it's not talking about a physical death, it's talking about a spiritual death. That we were spiritually dead. We're dead to God. We're dead to the purpose of God. We're dead to the voice of God. We're dead to the presence of God. We were dead to the will of God. We were dead because we did not have the life of God. And we had the nature of Satan, which is the nature of death. The wages of sin is death. And because of the original sin of Adam, it doesn't say that we became dead, it says we were dead. It was a past perfect tense, which means it was always that way. And yes, this is the very real reality of it, and that is that we don't really have, the first problem we have is not a sin problem, it's a life problem. We were born dead. And in a sense, as macabre as may sound, the world is a planet or a place of the living dead. People who are dead to God, dead to eternal life, dead to eternal purpose. And because we're dead to God and dead to the nature of God and the life of God, we were in trespasses and sins, as the Bible says, in them. In other words, we dwelled in that area, that lifestyle of trespasses and sins as a result of being dead in to the things of God. So the first thing that Jesus comes to do is to give us life. He says, "I've come that you might have life, and that you might have it more abundantly," because man's problem is a life problem. And if there's no life, there can be no victory over sin, over anything of darkness or of the devil. So he first comes to give us life. So the Bible says we were dead. So now, because we are born again and we are in Christ, this is history, praise God, that you were dead. You're not dead anymore, thank God. You're alive to God now. You have eternal life. You're alive to the things of God. You're alive to the purpose of God. You're alive to the voice of God, praise the Lord. You're no longer in your trespasses and sins as something swallowed up and surrounded by trespasses and sins, praise the Lord. That does not mean that we don't experience that or have trespasses and sins, because we're working out this salvation, we're growing in this salvation. So we do have the experience of having trespasses and sins. What's a trespass? A trespass is a transgression. It is a wrongdoing. Normally, a trespass is against people. It's against the family. It's against the community. It's against the nation. It's a trespass. It is not directly to God, but it is towards humanity. Sins are directly to God. It's an offense to God. It's a transgression against God. And so we were dead once. And that's the bad news. That was the history that we come from. And then it says, in which we formerly walked according to the age of this world and according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit who now works in the sons of disobedience. So we used to walk according to the age of this world, or according to the direction, the trends, the customs, the culture, the tendencies of the gravitational pull, if you will, of this world. This is how we used to be. We're no longer there now, but this is our past, praise the Lord. We are now moving against the grain of the world. We're moving against the trends and the customs and the cultures and the tendencies of this world. We are now moving against that force of gravity. Why? Because now we have life. Glory to God. So there's a thought for you today. You have life now. You're no longer dead in your trespasses and sins. Amen.